Good morning, students. Today we will start the topic S and I approach. In previous video, we talk about the short-term equilibrium output using aggregate demand and aggregate supply approach. Okay, so we have discussed about the table of aggregate demand, aggregate supply, then diagram. Now we will talk about S and I approach. Okay, S means saving. S means saving and I means investment. And I means investment. Okay, saving and investment approach that we will study. So firstly, we will talk about the saving. So what is saving? Saving is that part of income which people kept as अनकंज्यूम. ओके, मीन्स उसको कंज्यूम नहीं करते हैं. और वी कैन से द पार्ट ऑफ इनकम विच इज नॉट स्पेंड बाय द पीपल, जो कि वो स्पेंड नहीं करते हैं. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड सेविंग. एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट, इन्वेस्टमेंट मीन्स एक्सपेंडिचर ऑन द गुड्स विच आर यूज फॉर द फर्दर प्रोडक्शन. सो दैट इज इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो वी विल डिस्कस दिस टेबल. Here we are given income. So in AD and AS approach also we talk that starting income is zero, but there is minimum level of consumption. So that was the 20. Okay, means when income is zero, then consumption is 20. It means people are consuming something to survive. So consumption is that minimum consumption is necessary. It means income zero, consumption is 20. Then the saving will be in negative, minus. Okay, that will be negative. Then income increase from 0 to 20, then people consumption is 30. Here we can take, this is just for your understanding. Okay, and then consumption is 30. It means income increase and consumption also increase. When income increase from 20 to 40, then consumption is 40. Okay, so here Y and C both are equal. It means our savings are zero. Okay, but before that savings are in negative. Okay, minus. When income increase from 40 to 60, then consumption is 50. It means the people are not spending their entire income. They kept a part of income unspent. Okay, वो स्पेंड नहीं करते हैं एक पार्ट अपने इनकम का. इट मींस दैट इज द सेविंग ऑफ द पीपल. सो हियर 10 इज द सेविंग. ओके, 60 इज द इनकम, 50 इज कंजप्शन. मींस 50 रुपीज पीपल आर स्पेंडिंग एंड इट मींस 10 इज द सेविंग. देन द इनकम इंक्रीज फ्रॉम 60 टू 80 एंड हियर कंजप्शन इज 60, देन कंजप्शन इज 70 एंड देन इट इज 80. Okay, so you can see as income increasing, consumption is also increasing, but after a point. So this is the point where Y and C become equal. After that point, people consuming, but a part of income is used in for saving. Okay, ek income ka part saving mein use kiya jata hai. So you can see after that your saving started 10, 20, 30, 40. As income increase, saving also increasing. So there is a positive relation between income and saving. Now change in S. What is the change in S? Means to change has mein saving mein wo kitna ho raha hai. So you can see here the change is of 10, 10, 10. Okay. So this is about 10, 10, 10. Now we have change in Y. So humare Y mein kitna change ho raha hai? That is 20, 20. So the difference of we can say that Y is changing at a constant rate and saving is also changing at a constant rate. So there is a difference at a constant rate. There is difference in saving 10, 10, 10 and in income 20, 20, 20. Okay. Now we have I, investment. So this is the autonomous investment, as we already also talk an AD and AS approach. Okay, as Kinch talk about the autonomous investment, means the minimum level of investment that is necessary for the economy. Okay, and it is independent from the level of the income. So whatever the level of income, that does not affect the investment. You can see here, as income is increasing, but investment is constant, and this is the minimum investment that is required in the economy. Okay, so mainly autonomous investment is done by the government in the economy. Okay, so I investment, that autonomous investment, that is the minimum. So this table we will use in the diagram. Okay, on the basis of this table we will draw the diagram. So we will take O axis and O y axis. Okay, so here we will take Y and here we will take S and I. Okay, so as income started from the zero, then we can say 20 40 60 80 100 and 120. Then S and I, so we can see that our S is started from minus 20 and I is 10. Okay, so we will take 10 20 30 40 50 60. Okay, as I is minimum 10 or it is constant, so it will be parallel to O axis. Okay, I will be parallel to O axis. Why? Because it is constant. Autonomous investment is constant, or minimum level of autonomous investment is 10 in the economy. So this will be horizontal to the O axis. Okay, ये O axis का horizontal रहेगी, क्योंकि ये minimum investment है economy में, and जो minimum investment है उसका income से कोई effect नहीं पड़ रहा है. Income means income increase हो रही है, then also it is constant. It means it does not, there is no effect on the investment due to increase in income. Okay, so ये क्या हमारी line, constant horizontal line रहेगी. Then we have saving. So saving है हमारी जो minus 20 से start हो रही है, so these are the positive points. So we will take the point from here, minus 10. Here is saving 0. Okay, so we can see that saving point will start from here. Whenever income is 20, then saving are minus 20. Then income increase 40, then it is minus 10. Income is 60, then savings are 10. So saving will be like this. Okay, so this will be our saving point. This is saving. SS is our saving line. Okay, so as income is 0, then saving are minus 20. As income increase, then it is minus 10. And at the point of 60, when income is 60, we can say then our investment and S are equal. So this is the point of equilibrium point. Okay, equilibrium point. Here saving and investment both are equal to each other. Okay, so this E point is the point of equilibrium point. Why? Because here both saving and investment are equal in short period. Okay, what happen if S and I are not equal to each other? Here you can say savings are minus 10 but investment is 10. So what happen? Her aggregate expenditure that people plan to incur on the goods and services, that is more than compared to aggregate demand. It means जो हमारी aggregate demand है वो ज्यादा है compared to aggregate supply. What happens if S is greater than I? Okay, अगर saving ज्यादा है investment से तो क्या होएगा? Obviously, if savings are more than investment, it means people are expending less income on the purchase of goods and services, and the producer have unsold stock due to less of aggregate demand. Obviously, जब saving ज्यादा होने लगेगी economy में, तो जो goods की demand है वो less होगी. It means अगर goods की demand कम हो रही है, तो जो producer है, उनका जो stock है, that is remain unsold. Okay, and the producer will suffer from the loss of unsold goods in short period. Okay, and what happen if I is greater than S? अगर investment saving से ज्यादा होगी, what will happen? Obviously, investment is more than saving. It means there is more stock of goods. Okay, सेविंग है लेस है, इन्वेस्टमेंट ज्यादा है, तो इटमीन जो प्रोड्यूसर की इनकम है वो भी ज्यादा है, तभी तो ज्यादा इन्वेस्टमेंट हो रही है इकोनॉमी में. इट मीन्स एग्रीगेट डिमांड इज मोर देन एग्रीगेट सप्लाई. ओके, एग्रीगेट जो डिमांड है इकोनॉमी में वो ज्यादा है इससे एग्रीगेट सप्लाई से. ओके, सब डिमांड ज्यादा होगी देन ऑब्वियसली प्रोड्यूसर विल हैव मोर इनकम. मोर इनकम मीन्स मोर इन्वेस्टमेंट इन द इकोनॉमी. ओके, सो जो ये प्रोसेस है ये शॉर्ट पीरियड में चलता रहता है और दोबारा से जो इकोनॉमी है, अगर प्रोड्यूसर को क्या लगता है कि एग्रीगेट डिमांड ज्यादा हो रही है तो दे हैव द एक्सेस कैपेसिटी. दिस इज द अजम्पशन ऑफ दिस थ्योरी शॉर्ट रन इक्विलिब्रियम आउटपुट. ओके, सो एक्सेस कैपेसिटी है तो ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस करेंगे. ओके, और तब तक प्रोड्यूस करेंगे तब तक एस और आई एक दूसरे के इक्वल ना हो जाए. और यहाँ पे क्या है कि सेविंग ज्यादा हो रही है तो इट मीन्स अनसोल्ड स्टॉक है, देन द प्रोड्यूसर विल प्रोड्यूस लेस, वो कम प्रोड्यूस करेंगे और उस पॉइंट तक कम प्रोड्यूस करेंगे जब तक एस और आई दोनों शॉर्ट पीरियड में एक दूसरे के इक्वल ना हो जाए. ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द शॉर्ट रन इक्विलिब्रियम आउटपुट यूजिंग एस एंड आई अप्रोच. ओके, सो देन दीस थ्री अजम्पशन रिमेन इन द केंजियन थ्योरी. That there is excess capacity in the economy and short period, Keynes is the supporter of short period. Okay, so these are the assumptions that we have also talked in the previous videos. So S and I, and in previous video we talk about the AD and AS approach. Okay, so watch the video and also practice the diagram again and again. Okay, and if you face any problem, any doubt, you are free to ask. Thank you.